Hello, 7th standard students. In science, today we are going to see the lesson Health and Hygiene. Students, in which situation we are all these days? We all stay home from the impact of the coronavirus. The coronavirus has changed our daily activities. One of the reason for the increasing incidence of coronavirus is the deficiency of immunity in our body. Immunity in our body fight against the virus and bacteria to prevent the diseases. So, deficiency of immunity causes many diseases. Why should we isolate ourselves? We can prevent the spread of the disease if we isolate ourselves, so that the disease does not spread to others, because corona is the communicable disease. So dear students, in this health and hygiene lesson, we are going to understand about what is sickness, what are the causes for sickness, how can we prevent this illness. Then also we are going to know about communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. Health. What is health? Health is the absence of any disease or impairment. Health is the biggest wealth in life. Health brings in happiness, enjoyment, and pleasure. Given things in life are priceless and life cannot be purchased with money. Unless a person is healthy, it's difficult for him to enjoy his life. So health is a state of physical, mental and social well-being. Personal hygiene is how you care for your body. This practice includes bathing, washing your hands, brushing your teeth, and more. So hygiene refers to behaviors that can improve cleanliness and lead to good health. The behaviors such as frequent hand washing, face washing, and bathing with soap and water, etc., can lead to good health. Cleanliness is one of the most important practice for a clean and healthy environment. It may be related to public hygiene or personal hygiene. Cleanliness is essential for everyone. Cleanliness gives rise to a good character by keeping body, mind, and soul clean and peaceful. Maintaining cleanliness is the essential part of healthy living. So cleanliness only helps to improve our personality. Can you get sick if someone coughs on you? We know that germs causes diseases. Yes, the average cough expels about 20,000 viruses, which can infect a number of people. So coughing spreads droplets with germs like bacteria and viruses. These droplets remain suspended in the air for up to 10 minutes. The droplets be breathed in by other people. Bacteria and virus transmitted through air. How can you prevent these transmission of viruses? Cover your mouth and nose with a scarf or tissue when in public places. We can wear a mask. If someone in your household or school has a cough, try to keep distance from them. And do not share items like clothes and food. Stay away from crowds. to avoid contact with people who are sick. Community hygiene. This community hygiene concerns with betterment of the health and hygiene of our surroundings and people around us. Some health measures can be undertaken only by the people in a community. So the surrounding should be kept clean. Drains should be covered properly. Waste water should not be let out into open areas. Solid waste should be segregated and disposed properly. Care of the body. The human body is amazing. It is always working and growing. Parents take care of children's health. All the children must have everything they need to grow and maintain good health. Children take over some of the responsibility for taking care of their bodies. Our body needs several different kinds of care to function well. So dental care, eye care, then hair care. These are the different kinds of care to function well of the body. Dental care is the maintenance of healthy teeth, and dental care refers to oral hygiene. The mouth is an important part of the body. In the mouth are teeth that have three main jobs: smiling, talking, and eating. Our teeth allow us to smile and talk to others and eat food. So the practice of keeping the mouth and teeth clean in order to prevent dental disorders. To maintain healthy teeth and gums, we should follow these steps. Floss is an interdental cleaner. By using these floss, we can clean our teeth. Brush your teeth twice a day with a soft bristled toothbrush. Use fluoride toothpaste. Replace your toothbrush every 3 to 4 months or sooner if needed. Eat a healthy diet. Avoid sweets and sweetened drinks. Here some of the dental disorders and their remedial measures. Bleeding gums is caused by the deficiency of vitamin C. So it causes bleeding in the gums. So how can we prevent this bleeding gums? By eating citrus fruits like lemon and gooseberry, we can prevent this bleeding gums. Next defect is tooth decay. Mostly all the children are affected with tooth decay. The causative agent of the tooth decay is bacteria. While eating chocolates and sweets, the bacteria produce acids. So this acids leads to tooth decay. Brushing and flossing the teeth can prevent tooth decay. The next defect is periodontitis. The causative agent for periodontitis is tobacco chewing. Adults can chew often tobacco. So this severe form of gum disease, it can destroy the bones, gums, and other tissues of the mouth. So how can we prevent this periodontitis? Chewing type of tobacco should be avoided than by eating a well-balanced diet. Next, eye care. Why is eye care is important? Eyes are the important sense organ in our body. Eyes are considered as windows to the world. Your eyesight is one of your most important senses. 80% of what we perceive comes through our sense of sight. By protecting your eyes, you will reduce the defects of blindness and vision loss. So, what are the diseases affecting the eye and their remedial measures as follows? Night blindness. It is caused by a lack of vitamin A. So, night blindness is a disorder of the cells in your retina of the eye. So, night blindness makes it hard to see well at night or in poor light. Person with night blindness do not able to see clearly at poor light. How can we prevent night blindness? By eating foods rich in antioxidants, vitamins and minerals. Next defect is conjunctivitis. Conjunctivitis is caused by a virus and bacteria. It is otherwise called as pink eye. One or both eyes can be affected. Highly infectious disease. It can be spread by contamination and sneezing. So by using antibiotics, eye drops or ointments gives remedy. Next defect is color blindness. It is a genetic disorder. The person with the color blindness difficult to distinguish the colors between red and green. So they can inability to see shades or tones of the same color. So they can't able to identify the different colors, red and green. There is no known cure for color blindness. Contact lenses and glasses with filters can help to prevent the color blindness. Hair care. The condition of the hair reflects our general health of the body. Healthy hair reflects good healthy nutritional status of our body. Loss of hair reflects our poor nutritional status of the body. Unless the hair is washed regularly, the oil, sweat and dead cells all add together and make the hair greasy and look dirty. So, how can we keep our hair clean and healthy? Regular hair wash, massage of the scalp, rinsing hair with clean water, hair dressing using good tooth comb. These helps to keep our hair clean and healthy. So, dear students, we will see about the diseases, communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases in the next video. Thank you, students.